It's about that time, baby, baby. Oh, yeah. Here we go, here we go.
This is Claire Show is on.
It is on.
Running with your friends, come on.
Come on, come on.
This is a moment of the show tonight. Mailbag is tight. Claire's on the mic.
Once again, it's on. You're still troubled in your home. Got your tripping, don't know right from wrong. Calling your letters to the show so we can talk you through. Get the answers to your questions because we see that truth. Sometimes you doubt yourself, lost your health. Faith is on the fence, but you believe that Jesus knows your wealth. Keep it moving, spirit flowing because we're here to provide someone to lean on when you're falling. Wednesday, 8 and 9, and it's on.
Once again, it's on. You're listening to the only morning show at night, people. It's the Sinclair Show in partnership with WBISLP, Awesome Radio 106.9, and Greenville Pit Access Television TV 23. The Sinclair Show is sponsored by Carver Cigars. What's your Carver moment? And the interdenominational spiritual training, where increasing your knowledge and relationship with God goes hand in hand. You can catch the Sinclair Show on Sinclair TV, GPAT TV 23. Check your local listings for times and dates. You can also watch on Facebook at The Sinclair Show. Well, 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 if it isn't a good evening in the virtual hood, what's going on with my people? Glad that everybody is joining us this evening. I know some of y'all got them storms brewing in your neighborhood, but it's all right because we about to have some fun tonight. Let me see who's the first up. First of all, I want to thank all of you all who continue to send your mailbag questions and comments and DMs and phone calls and all of the above. Yeah, that right there. But we're going to continue to address each and every one that we can each night we on the air to reach you, the valued listener. That's right. It's interactive. So that means when you reach out to me, I reach out to you. We talk about what's on your mind. And sometimes it can get a little bit iffy, but it's all right because I still got y'all. Because that's how we get down. First person on tonight is Jay Dizzle. Johnny Key was popping off. He been out there all day giving the man his just due. Gwendolyn Lady Elegance Pritchett. She's coming to us from Rocket City, Alabama. Then we got Pamela, Detective Pamela Black. What's going on, girl? Glad that you are joining us this evening. Oh, her. Nikki Carter's back with us, people. She ain't been excommunicated from the show just yet. Annie Moore, what's going on? Glad to see you. Hey, mama. What's going on, mama? Mama, it's been a lot of activity at your house today. I'm gonna have to call you because I was watching them cameras. I seen a lot of people circulating through them doors. I got to figure out what's going on. Cassandra Key, what's going on with the Legal Beagle? And everybody there's the big homie, Rod Jake, in the house. Let me see. Nikki Carter talking about the shade. Nikki, you ought to be happy you even own the show. You've been supposed to be kicked off the show a couple of times. Only thing to save you is the people spoke and they spoke up on your behalf. But I didn't let it be known. You get out of pocket today. Screw it. You're out of here. That's how we get down on the show. We don't have time for the tomfoolery. But look, people, let me tell you what we do have time for. We got some. I'm trying to wait till my homie get on the show. Let me see. What is Jay Dizzle talking about? Yeah, whatever. What's the up with the homie? Yeah, you keep thanking the people. People can't say you on the next time. That only works once. Matter of fact, I'm going to check with the Legal Beagle, because if the Legal Beagle say I can kick you off the show without any repercussions in the legal system, Cassandra, is it possible for me to ban Nikki Carter from the show without there being any legal repercussions? If she say I could get rid of you, you out of here. So you better hope that the legal system is on your side, because it might not be. All right. So I'm actually trying to wait for my homie Andre Williams to get up here, because look, he done threw me in the fire. He hit me up yesterday. Nigga, you talking about no, you can't, girl, please. You so close to being out of here. If you look out your window, you can see out of here right now, because that's where you're going to be at. Ty Matthews, what's going on? So, yeah, some of this, what's the business is my evergreen brother digging the hat. Jay Dizzle, you know, sometime I got to get down with the forestry colors because we about to get in them weeds today. So I needed to be able to be incognito today. So we got a couple of hot topics and I'm going to tell y'all how I'm going to play this today. I kind of want to start off with Big Rod said, Johnny Key, what's up, man? I kind of want to start off with this one particular topic, but the problem is Andre Williams gave me this topic. And I know I'm going to have to, I know the Me Too movement going to come out when I set it off. Ty said, that beard is looking right spiffy today. Why, thank you. See, that's what I'm talking about. Jay Dizzle said he's doing well. You know how we do. See, that's what I'm talking about. See how the compliments come? That right there keep you on the show, even if you do something a little out the pocket. Jay Dizzle, what's up? Hold on. First of all, Nikki Carter, let's make it clear. You don't get to use my brotherhood names with people. You don't even, you can't even call them Jay Dizzle. You don't even know nothing about that. Cassandra, can you tell me if I can kick off the show without there being any complications legally? Oh, y'all in trouble now. There go my brother Andre Williams. Oh, Andre, we get ready to set it off with the public right now here in a second. You look so nice today, love that. It's sarcasm when it's coming from you. You still getting kicked off the show. Anyway, listen, people. First of all, let me do my public service announcement. So I was watching y'all boy Dr. Fauci today, right? Being involved in acting, whatever. I was watching Dr. Fauci today. And old Dr. Fauci is running around hollering about y'all need to mask up. And now he's saying that them boosters that y'all be getting, they only last for a little while. So he's trying to, she said, no, it's a genuine compliment. You know how when people talk like you, it just make you feel like it ain't. Feel like it's some snakery going on. But anyway, so Fauci now is trying to promote. Y'all might have to get some more shots. Now, I'm telling y'all, I'm no longer playing with Fauci. I don't trust Fauci. Y'all better get you some masks, put your mask on, rock with your mask, and stay away from people. Because I'm telling you, it's out there. Hey, and somebody tell me, do I got any nurses or anything? Somebody tell me, Camille the other day sent me something talking about the monkeypox. What is y'all doing out here with the monkeypox now? We having a real life contagion. Y'all ever seen that movie Contagion with Morgan Freeman in it? And I think Dustin Hoffman was in it too. And it was one little monkey that caused, that got out, you know how y'all be selling the underground monkeys and stuff, right? I don't even know why I, as a black man, as a Negro man, well, 53% is out here talking about monkeys. It's so just disrespectful anyway. But let me tell you what got me. When I saw, Nikki Carter said that was Outbreak. It was a movie called Contagion 2. Ooh, I can't stand her. Anyway, so let me tell y'all. So I'm sitting around and they talking about the monkeypox. Now somebody tell me what's up with the monkeypox. What how you get monkeypox? And what is monkeypox? Matter of fact, let's begin with it. Does anybody even know what monkeypox is? I'm just saying. Anyway, so we don't get bogged down and have a loss for time because my brother Andre Williams has set it off for us tonight. I'm just gonna tell y'all. It's so much stuff out here, you might want to put them bubble suits on, them orange suits that your homies be walking around with. You might need to get you one of them and put it for the revolution kit. Some of y'all ain't got no revolution kit. I got a revolution kit. I'm prepping. Y'all don't do the preppery, but I'm prepping, all right? So anyway, Barry Horton, what's going on, my brother? He said probably something they made in the lab. Hey, I don't know, man. It might be, but I know they talking about monkeypox. They talking about this new strain of COVID. I don't even think we ought to call it COVID-19 no more. We ought to be calling it COVID-22. Because I'm telling you, it's out here. And old Fauci done popped back on the scene. If they hadn't told y'all, y'all could get out here without these masks and y'all was safe to frolic in the sand, if you will, y'all wouldn't be around here with all this mess. Now y'all got y'all running to the hospital again, talking about give me the injections. I'm not messing with y'all. Stay away from me. Then you ain't got to have no problems. All right? But look, people, so let me go ahead and run this across the screen. Now, if any of you all, any of you, saw the little notification, all right, the notification came from one of our brothers, Brother Andre Williams, and I saw it on his page yesterday because, you know, I'll be perusing, looking for some intellectual dialogue that is important to the community, if you will. And I scrolled by old Andre's page, bing, 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 and it popped up. And I'm going to tell you what I saw, okay? I saw the image. Well, there was a, matter of fact, I think my brother had threw a challenge out there. And anytime I see somebody say, I bet you won't talk about this, though, it always perks Uncle Cindy Sin's mindset because I'm like, it must be deep. So the question behind the image was, is a toxic mother more detrimental to a child's life than an absent father? Okay. I know that's deep for some of y'all. I can already feel some of y'all blood boiling. Hey, I'm the messenger tonight. I didn't even create the message. But I rocks with Andre on this because let me describe the imagery that was up there. The image that was on Brother Williams' Facebook in this particular question showed an image of a woman who had a cell phone in her hand, and she was standing up and she appeared to be nude. And she was taking pictures of herself or she was on a video chat. I don't know which one, because it was a still shot, of course. And her daughter, her young daughter, was standing in the doorway saying, Mom. And the caption then made sense to me. And so the question, and let me put this disclaimer out here for Andre and myself. Whenever we are talking about something, we are not talking about all of anything. When we talk about men, we're not talking about all men. When we talk about women, we're not talking about all women. When we're talking about Negroes, we're not talking about all Negroes and Anglo-Saxons. We're not talking about all of anything. We're talking about those that fit into a particular category. And in this case, it was a well thought out question. And so we're going to talk about that for a minute tonight. Again, I want you to picture in your mind, if you're not Facebook friends with Andre Williams, the image was a black woman and it was a cartoon character. It was not like a real picture of a real woman, but it was a cartoonish type woman who was standing. Yes, she happened to be a Negro woman. She happened to be standing in her room, what appeared to be her room, and she had her phone up and she was taking either a selfie or she was doing a video call or something, but she was nude. Meaning she was sending out the imagery or showing somebody whatever she was working with. And her daughter, her young black daughter, was standing in the doorway watching her. And so the caption that came across asked the question, is a toxic mother more detrimental to a child's life than an absent father? What say you all out there in listening land? Taking that specific situation into consideration, nothing more, nothing less. And considering, is or are there situations where we as a society are focusing on so much of negative energy toward men? Ah, Andre, we already got one, and you knew who it was going to be. That one. But when we have no problem as a society talking about the flaws of men, especially those who are not present or physically present or part of the custodial parenting process, if you will, we talk about them, and in many cases, rightfully so. So I'm not defending all, although we've already discussed on this show that in many cases, it has nothing. It does not mean that they are a bad father because they are not part of the custodial process. They may still be active. So I'm not putting it on all men because I believe men get a bad rap. But what about, we've been given some women, not all, because some are very, very good parents, and these things would never apply to them in the first place. But if you are a mother and you are allowing your daughter or your kids in general to see you in your room naked, taking pictures or sending imagery out over the cell phone, what is more worse? Brother Roz said, when you are being raised by a toxic person, you are more likely to start thinking or acting like them, especially if the mothers keep telling you that your father or dad isn't sugar, honey, iced tea. Uh-oh, Big Rod done laid the foundation for what we're talking about. Nikki Carter, let me put that up because I want y'all to be able to see that, because that's education right there. That's knowledge. Nikki Carter said, any toxic parent is detrimental to a child. Hold on, Nikki Carter. Let's go back to the beginning. See, this that reason why I be wanting to kick you off the show. Because the question wasn't, is any toxic parent detrimental to a child? Why is it that y'all have such, it's like pulling teeth to get you all to say the answer to the question that's asked? The question was very simple. Is a toxic mother more detrimental to a child's life than an absent father? It wasn't if you find two toxic people, X, Y, Z. Brother William said it's simple. Children mimic the adults. What they see, what they do, if I see mommy do it, it's okay for me to do it. Hey, Andre, I told y'all, Andre done baselined you all tonight. So, Nikki Carter, you said no what? You're saying no, a toxic mother isn't more detrimental to a child than an absent father? Is that what you're saying no to? I want to give you a chance to make clarity or make a fool of yourself one of the two ways. I don't care how you do it, but I want to make sure I'm understanding what you're saying. Because this is what bothers me. Now, I got all these women that's up here, done popped up here, that's out here in listening land, and none of y'all got nothing to say tonight. But I know if this was a topic, okay, he gave a generic answer to. He who? He who? Let me see. Ty said, if the toxic mother is the custodial parent, I would say yes. Now, there is a balanced answer. See, that's what get me, though, people. I got women all over the country that's in one of these three forms, and I can't get y'all to say nothing. And then some of you all, which I don't expect no more from somebody with the demeanor on this show as Nikki to try to find a weasel way of saying, well, and let me go back, because I don't want y'all to think I'm making up what she said. These are her words. Any toxic parent. I didn't ask you about any toxic parent. We want to know if we can at least get. Y'all know how I'm always saying that. Andre, she's trying to say you gave a generic answer. No, he answered the question. Let's go back. He said it's simple. children mimic the adults, what they see, what they do. He said, if I see mommy do it, it's okay for me to do it. That ain't generic. He answered the question. What she talking about, Lord? Don't start trying to talk to the Lord. Lord ain't even messing with you. April Brown, what's going on? For those of you who are just joining us, the first topic hot off the press came from Brother Andre Williams. He had this this thing on his Facebook page, and he asked the question. First, he said, I know y'all ain't even gonna tackle this subject, but he asked the question, is a toxic mother more detrimental to a child than an absent father? And the image that he had, again, this is for the people just joining us. The image that he had on this screen was a cartoon character of a woman, a black woman who was standing in her room or in a room with her cell phone up. She was naked, taking pictures of herself, and her daughter was in the doorway, what appeared to be the doorway, saying, mommy, as if saying, man, what is you doing? And so he asked that question, is a toxic mother more detrimental to a child than an absent father? And already we've got old Nikki Carter around here. Hold on, she talking about some next topic. You don't determine when the next topic, because you ladies out here, y'all gonna give me some answers today. I'm not letting y'all walk the plank on this one and slide. Anytime we talking about something dumb or ignorant or negative that a man do, y'all jump right off into the pool and y'all will talk about it all day long. And I got two people that to answer the question that are women. Ladies, come on now. Y'all, if I switch topics to talking about deadbeat dads or Negroes that ain't about nothing, y'all will speak up all day. Ty said, a toxic mother can definitely be detrimental to the emotional psyche of her child without question. See, that's what I'm talking about. Just honesty. That's all we're looking for. That's inappropriate, period. That ain't the question. I didn't ask you whether it was inappropriate. You just ain't gonna never say nothing. And I know for a fact, based on the responses that I have gleaned from Nikki Carter over the months that she's been popping on the show, if not longer, that she is as close to the Me Too movement. She probably the president of the Me Too movement and just don't want her name out there. And it's okay. I'm not mad at anybody that's pro-woman, just like I don't get mad if you're pro-man. I don't get mad if you're pro-white or pro-black or pro-Asian or pro-Hispanic. I don't care about that. But we lose credibility when we can't just verbally say something definitive to say, look, if you have this kind of woman doing this in front of her child, yes, it is far more detrimental than an absent father because she's influencing. You can't get Nikki Carter to say that for nothing in the world. Why? Because she refuses to answer an honest question. Abram said, I don't know. It's more detrimental, but it's equally damaging. Another Me Too movement candidate. Okay, so Abram, let me ask you a question. You said you don't know it's more detrimental. So are you saying to me that a male not being a custodial parent, but doing the things that he's supposed to do, is somehow equally detrimental to a child as her seeing her mama standing up, taking naked pictures and sending them out, or being on video naked. You trying to tell me, and that's just one incident. The question was about toxic in general, but I'm giving that because it was up there. I'm trying to understand how you gonna tell me you don't know if it's more detrimental. But an absent father is long-term. Oh, so you saying, hold on, well, what's short-term about a toxic mother? Andre said, influencing is the key. Absolutely. Big Rod said the mother's actions can in some cases will determine how the daughter will act around men and how boys will treat women. Hey, Brother Rod, you own to something. Nigga said, we don't have enough information to make a determination whether the mother is toxic or not. Girl, get up out of here with that. Let me ask you a question. Are you saying you don't believe that it is a toxic for a mother to be standing up with her cell phone, taking nude pictures of herself or videoing nude and her daughter to see? You don't think that's toxic activity? How would you describe it then? What part of that do you think might not be toxic? Let's start with that. Dr. Beverly Key, you know we always glad to see you. It's a meme. No. You're not riding off into the sunset with that foolishness. Andre said they probably want us to explain absent. Absent can just mean not in the home, but still active. Absolutely. And I think, Brother Williams, I think that's what I conveyed when I said to them, he is not in the home as a custodial parent, but he's doing everything else he's supposed to do. Johnny said that scenario is the definition of toxicity. All right, whew, got a little problem. Glad to see you too, friend. All right, she said non-existent. Listen. All right, let me just ask this question so that maybe I can get Nikki Carter to get her Usher on, her confession on. Are you saying today that you don't find it to be toxic behavior if a woman who has a daughter or son is taking images or videos of herself nude and sending them on her phone and they are watching, you don't think that's toxic behavior? Is that what you're saying? Abel said, oh, I thought you were referring to the dead being a deadbeat. No, that wasn't, I'm not adding anything. I'm just talking about the imagery. Okay. Let me see. I'm not saying that at all. Well, exactly. What are you saying? All right. An involved father is not absent just because he's not in the home. Okay. Ty said, I was always under the impression that an absent father was a father that was not involved at all. When I hear women talk about absentee fathers, they are not talking about participating dads who don't live with them. They're talking about men who are ghosts. Okay. It was inappropriate behavior. Nikki Carter, was it toxic? I'm not asking you to rephrase to something that sounds cute, because you certainly don't rephrase to something that sounds cute when you're talking about a negative male. I want you to say and answer the question. Do you consider it to be toxic behavior? Okay. It was, I was late, didn't see the image or hear the initial conversation. All right. That's correct, Ty. All right. So let me break this down. If this is what you all want to rest your hat on, I'm gonna give you this. I'm gonna lay it out so y'all have something to chew on. Let's say hypothetically that the absent father is all the way out, as you all want to portray him as being ghost. He ain't got nothing to do with the child. Okay. Is him not having anything to do with the child worse than a mother who is active in the child's life, but giving that type of training? How about that? Okay. Andre said, well, whether the father is involved or not involved or involved, if mom is at home taking booty selfies for her daughter to see, that sad, sad, sad business. That's real talk right there. So I done phrased it for you all in this way. Is it more toxic for somebody to be in your life and be introducing you to all types of negative energy, bad behavior, things like that, than somebody who's not in your life at all? Which one is more detrimental? Let's ask that question. Annie Moore said, it's toxic behavior because that child probably thinks it's all right to do that because she saw mommy do it. So one day she might try it too. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you, Jesus. You finally got me somebody down here, a woman that's willing to just break it down like that. No, with an absentee father and a mother who is displaying toxic behavior, it is truly detrimental psychologically and emotionally to the child because that's all they have to draw on. That's what I'm talking about. And we're not, understand something. We're not justifying the father not being active at all. Abra said, a toxic mom is very damaging to a child. A son or daughter holds their mom to a standard of what is expected in life. Them seeing their mom displaying that behavior sets a tone for dysfunctional behavior later for the child. There we go. Now we get into some knowledge out here. James Key, what's going on, man? Andre said, the example being seen is more detrimental, in my opinion. Absolutely. That's the whole point that I'm trying to say. It's like, and ladies, I want y'all to understand something. The problem is, in many cases, when you all fail to acknowledge, I understand the sisterhood. Matter of fact, men, I wish we had the type of bond that women have in the sisterhood. I imagine we could do powerful things if we stuck together the way women do. But ladies, sometimes you sticking together just because you in the women's Me Too movement and being unwilling to acknowledge flaws and faults. Remember, I gave the disclaimer. We're not talking about all women. I gave the disclaimer up front that, hey, it's a lot of good women. We're talking about women that do that thing, okay? Brother Sizemore said, I've seen firsthand as an educator, toxic moms can really influence children negatively. I agree. Andre said, they do stick together. Hey, bruh, listen to me when I tell you, y'all got a serious bruh code. Stop playing. Now, let me tell you something, Ty. I haven't found a creature that exists on earth that sticks together greater than the women and certainly Negro women. Y'all, for the most part, y'all could see one of y'all's out here acting the absolute fool and y'all will blame it on the man. Well, she's only out here acting crazy because something he did to her. And the whole question tonight was about which is more detrimental, a toxic mother, and we gave examples of that. Let me tell you something. If a child, and I told you, the image that was up there was a mother, and it was her daughter who was in the doorway who was questioning her about saying, Mom, like, what is you doing? That's the optics that we were given. But let me say this. Somebody already put it out there. If you are a woman and you let your child, but especially your daughter, see you doing these things. Now, that little girl probably was maybe 8, 9 years old at best. Okay. And if you let them see you doing this, then it's okay. That's why so many young girls grow up to be grown women who are relationship deficient, because what did they have to witness? Y'all will let them see you in there taking your little naked selfies. Y'all will let them go through your phones and tablets and see all the dudes that you're out there running with. All these things that y'all do, you're influencing at a point that you don't even understand. You might grow out of it at some point. Probably not, but you might. All right. Abra said, parents, regardless if they are together or not, can teach, show proper love for their mate, but showing, teaching their child that level of ratchetness and or approves of it is damaging to the child, their future relationships, and what they should expect from their mate. Absolutely. Let me see. You doing like Nikki, LOL. Esther Shepherd, what's going on? Glad to see you. So when I say this to you all, and I want y'all to think about it, and again, first of all, I want to thank Andre. I don't know what caused him to have this on his page, but it was impactful and it was a good question. And it should cause us to think. I don't want you guys to come to the Sinclair Show and Robin Williams, what's going on? Glad to see you. I don't want y'all to come to the Sinclair Show and everything we do is just joke around with each other. And there's nothing that we think about, or you don't leave with anything that's on your mind that will cause you to think. We have real problems in our homes and in our communities, and we've got to address them, and we got to address them head on. And we got to try to work through some of these kinks that we have. If you can't call a spade because you latched on to this code, it's no different than some of y'all got kids in your house right now that's robbing and beating up folks, and you sit around like you don't know who doing it. Some of y'all got kids breaking into cars and stealing every day and coming back to your house with all the stolen stuff, but that's your baby, so you gonna protect it. Some of y'all so busy protecting, and I wonder, are you protecting the child, or are you protecting what you believe to be your image as a parent? You know your child ain't got no job, but your child got more money in the bank than you. Every time something shout, they coming and breaking you off with some money. And you ain't asking no questions because you already know. The toxic behavior, what you're out here saying about men. Let's say you had a bad relationship. Let's say you was actually involved with a deadbeat, a physically abusive person, whatever. Let's say those things to be true. How you handle it impacts that child and how they grow up. All right, so Andre says, piggybacking on from Brother Sizemore, I've seen it firsthand from a mental health professional point of view. The mom allowing a man to mistreat them in front of a child, male or female, is several issues that can be added. The child, male or female, will mimic that parent. Absolutely. And it's important that we understand that. We've been saying for years that if a son sees his father drinking or abusing or womanizing, I've even said, if you a man and you got kids, ain't no way you should be taking no woman over to the other woman's house. It sets the wrong tone, and it shows a level of disrespect to the mother. I agree when we had those conversations. My problem is that we can't get the respect due that y'all will just stand up and say, hey, if you're doing these things, it's wrong. Because you got women that'll take they sons and daughters over to their side dude's house. So don't act like this is just a male thing. It's wrong. It's wrong. The problem is many women ain't gonna say it's wrong. They will find a justification for it. There is no justification when it's a man doing it. And we all agree. Men agree. Women agree. But when it's a woman doing it, all of a sudden, Nikki Carter talking about I'm back. We didn't even know that you was gone. We didn't even care. We just thought you had finally done grew up for a minute. And ladies, that's what you have to understand. Those that are out here doing the ratchetness, they got friends and homegirls that won't even say nothing to them about it. And that thing right there, Ty said, there's no justification anywhere around it. They said, I said it was wrong. Whatever. You know what? It took you too long to get there. You only said it because you saw your homegirls out there stepping up to the plate and you didn't want to get lost in the fray. I say these things to you all because as a society, certainly in the Negro community, we are experiencing a high level of dysfunction, and you can't solve a problem that you're unwilling to admit is a problem. Okay? That's the truth. You can't help stop a behavior that it's depending on who's doing it when you think it's a problem. Abra said, if mom has no respect for herself or her children, they will lose respect for her and self. It's a sad situation all the way around. It will breed a continual cycle of dysfunction within the generation and create generational curses. Sounds like a winner. Nigga said, no, I had to leave for a minute. Nobody's talking about you. Andre said, that's definitely possible. That's definitely a way to look at it. Brother Sizemore said, I got nothing but love for our sister Nikki. Yeah, well, you're going to have to tell her what happened on the show because she getting put off the show. She keep on. But I'm telling you, it was worth the time we invested in this topic. And ladies, I say this all the time. I know it sounds like I'm tough on issues like this where women are involved, but I'm tough like that because there is no person who impacts our generations greater than women. And the sadness of us not having the types of real dialogue or us having double standards, you know, trifling is trifling. It doesn't matter who's doing it. And I'm not telling you all, I'm not your judge. I'm not your priest or your pastor. I'm not judging that woman that was the optics of that woman who was had her cell phone and taking them pictures. That ain't even what I'm talking about. Nigga said, thank you, sir. I appreciate your support. Here Nail go talking about letting Nikki live. I'm telling y'all, she's going to be out of here. The problem isn't the imagery. And I want to separate the two. As a grown adult, you can do what you want to do. I just say, Nikki is okay. Yeah, everybody want to let her stick around. People like troublemakers. Her taking the pictures as a grown woman, while it might not be advised, it's her business. But her doing it with the door open or with her child watching, and even when her child is saying something to her about it, she ain't got no remorse about the situation, is the problem. I'm not getting down on people. If you out here and you got something else going on for whatever reason in your life, hey, that's between you and your situation or whatever. But when you're comfortable allowing your kids to know, to see, to be involved, to read your texts, to see your images and all these things, that's the problem. Not the fact that you grown and want to do it. Nikki needs to stay to get better because she needs to be enlightened. Okay, we're gonna let Nikki get enlightened. You see what James said. Let me find out you have a fan base. Well, apparently, y'all got some free Nikki Carter t-shirts or something, whatever. But I want y'all to understand, because I don't want y'all leaving saying, because some of y'all are probably saying it but didn't want to type it, that whatever that woman do is her business. You're right. It is her business as an adult. But when you're comfortable allowing your kids to see that type of foolery is the toxic problem. Not that you feel comfortable doing it. Whatever you feel comfortable doing in your skin is between you and God. And if you left it there, it wouldn't be any problem. But you're using it as a teaching tool. What do you think it says? What if you could go back and see the girl's facial expression when she sees her mom doing it? The little girl who couldn't be greater than 7 or 8 knew it was wrong. So imagine when they hear you on the phone and they know you ain't talking to dad, you talking to the other dude, right? When they hear that, what do they think? When they see you read the text messages because you allow them to go through your phones and see what messages the other dudes are sending you, whatever. What do you think that sends? That's the message. It's not that you're doing it. It's that you so comfortable. These your little homies. And men, it's the same way. It's no badge of honor for a man. If you got a son and you out here doing whatever you doing, we're not judging you on that right now. different topic, different day. But we are judging you if you will allow your son to see you out here doing these things, because you're teaching him that behavior. The only reason why we're talking it from a woman's perspective is because that's what the question was that appeared on Andre's page. That's what the optics were. We're saying it's wrong if anybody does it. If you want to do something because it's what you do, hey, knock yourself out. But that you're comfortable teaching it to your child, you're comfortable letting them see, you're comfortable letting them hear, you're comfortable having them in your adult world doing this, then how do they ever become anything other than relationship deficient? That right there. People have to realize that children need to be respected. Absolutely. Annie Moore says she didn't have any respect for her daughter. Evidently, she didn't think there was anything wrong with it. And you know what? That could be the case, but Annie Moore, I doubt that that's the case, that she didn't think it was anything wrong with it. I think she was more into what she was doing than that concern. I said that it didn't matter who did it. Why in the world would you want your child to see you on any level as anything other than a parent? We not cool, not friends. I'm mom and set the standard. They are the child and learn from my example. That's how it should be. Nikki Carter said, let her pull up the transcript. Whatever, pull it up. That is the problem. Absolutely. So anyway, we're going to move on from this because I know I'm going to get some hate mail about it. But I wanted y'all to understand that it is, we have to move to a space in our own communities that if we want our young people to be something different, we have to show them something different. Andre said, I was at a grocery store last week and this mother was cussing her little girl out like she was a grown woman. I had to tell her she should not be cussing at that baby like that. I felt so bad for the child. I didn't want to agree with the lady, but I asked, what kind of mom are you? She told me to mind my business, but didn't cuss at me. Right. Cause she ain't want to get that. She ain't want to have get that business. Jane said, the mindset is do as I say, not as I do. Yeah. But the problem with that analogy is if you want a child to do what you say, then show them what they ought to be doing. If you out here being that, as somebody said, that ratchet, what do you think about yourself? What kind of relationship do you have with your child that you're that comfortable with them seeing you with that behavior? Because it don't make you no hero. And I'm saying this to men. Men taking their sons over somebody else's house, it don't make you no hero. It don't make you look like you big time. If your son is cheering on that behavior, he's going to be that dude. All right? Anyway, let us move on because I did want to get one other thing in. And I think I was having this conversation with... it might have been Jay Dizzle. I don't know for sure. But we were talking about the mindset of why do we as a race of people, the Negroes, why are we still latching on to every time something comes up, we're talking about slavery. And if I am correct, and he's up here, so if I get it wrong, I'm sure he could correct me on it. Johnny's philosophy was at some point we have to move forward and not let that be the baseline that we bring up with every issue that comes into our lives. And I understood what he was talking about. Okay. Hold on, I got one more thing from Andre on the last issue. Said, hey, James, they won't do it in front of the mom, but they may do it away from home. Absolutely. And so I understood what Johnny was saying from the perspective, I believe, and he can correct me if I'm wrong. I believe what he was trying to say is that we have to stop accepting a crutch. I took a slightly different position as to... um, American Negroes feel the way they do and can't move past it because we are one of, if not the only, race of individual that there have been no reparations provided of any sort. And I'm not talking about the 40 acres and a mule because America doesn't have that land to give anyway. But I am talking about when something happened with the Native American Indians, they provided restitution. When something happened, and we had nothing to do with the Holocaust, and America still found a way to provide reparations. When we went over to Vietnam and had conflicts over there, every time we went somewhere and tore up something and did something, we provided reparations and restitution. Even in the Middle East conflicts, at the end of the process, we sent in cargo planes full of cash over there. We're making reparations and restitution. And so we expect that in some cases that Negro Americans should move past. But if what well, Matt, and so the question was, what would happen if America decided we're going to go ahead and give some reparations? And would that then do exactly what white America has been asking for years, which is us to move forward? It'll be pretty hard for you to keep saying something if you got reparations. Now, I said to Johnny, I believe that white America, that 42.5% of me, I believe that what they are comfortable with is the conflict. And I often say this about relationships in general. There is a demographic of people who are comfortable when there is conflict in the home, and they become nervous when there's peace. I can attach that theory to white America. As long as we don't give reparations to the Negroes, we can keep them up in arms about something all the time. And they're not looking at or focused on this over here because they're still thinking about that. Okay. And I believe that the conflict is what they need to be happening to have us sidetracked. Because truly, Andre said they gave slave owners money for freeing the slaves. America paid reparations. We blacks, our ancestors, just didn't get it. Absolutely. They wanted to make the slave owners whole, as they stated, because they were forced to give up something that they paid for. Absolutely. You are 100% right. But I'm asking to my Caucasian comrades, is that the key to what we're dealing with? Is that there is a greater fear of what happens when the Negroes don't have anything to argue about? Will they shift their dichotomy, their chain of thought, to something more powerful? Okay. Like you said, no apologies, no acknowledgement, nothing. Right. And so I want you all to think about that, white America, because I want you to comprehend that we are no longer just sitting back and not considering all of these things. If you have the ability to give, to go and give billions of dollars, $80 billion to the Ukraine, which I believe they deserve the support. If you can come up with money to send to the Middle East to do planes, and Obama did it too. He sent the plane over there with the money on it. If you had the ability to do that, that would mean they admit they were wrong. Ain't going to happen. Okay. James, I don't think that they're denying that it was wrong. I just believe that they know if we no longer can talk about that because they paid the bill, because they cut the check, then our mind is going to shift And we're going to start deep diving into the real foolery that goes on. Because trust me, if they said they was going to give 100 million people $100,000, it wouldn't break the bank. That's just simply the truth. Sending reparations and assistance to other countries is like feeding your neighbor's kids and starving your own. That's a good point, Ty. So I want us to begin to think about that. And we're not going to have time to deep dive like I would like tonight. And we can pick this up next week. But I want you all to ponder this week what you think about it. Is the reason why America does not want to provide the American Negro reparations far more sinister than just the money? Is it that they don't want us to calm down from that and focus on other stuff that's important? Like, if we took our minds and we really started watching everything that's done in the government, everything that's done with laws, is that the problem? They don't want us focused on that. They don't mind us arguing about cops killing blacks. They don't mind us focused on that because that just keeps us angry. They don't want us calm and educated. They want us angry with a bunch of calamity going on around us. That way we're not focused. And are we playing into that by not educating ourselves on today's issues? I'm not saying give them a pass, but we got to be thinking about why are they so comfortable letting this ride? All right. Let me see. I got one other thing I wanted to, you know what? I'm going to go and cover this one. So y'all might have to stay with me a few seconds longer. All right. What does Ty say? Angry, disorganized, disheartened, hopeless, etc. James said, who has apologized for slavery that matters? Reparations would, you know what? The people, certainly wasn't the people back then, but I've heard many a president who have verbalized it. Whether they meant it or not is irrelevant. They continue to perpetrate our trauma. Okay. Now, if you look down at the bottom of the screen, this is something that I really want you guys to take seriously. All right. Johnny said they want to continue to subvert us as a people, ignore and subvert. All right. I'm rocking with that. And what I wanted to get across with this point that's scrolling at the bottom of the screen is this. We need to stop with these social media pranks before some more people get killed. A man recently had to be restrained from choking another man because of a prank he did, and the person that he did the prank on didn't know it was a prank. Last year in Tennessee, a man was shot and killed for pretending to rob somebody, and he was doing it for social media. Listen, people. I cannot say this enough. Stop playing with folks out here in these streets. These people got a lot going on in their life. A lot of people are on edge. You don't know what they went through last night. You don't know what they went through when they was at work today. You don't know what they went through this morning before they set off to go to work. And you out here playing and pranking for clicks and likes. And there's people around here that ain't got time for you to play with them. If that's the best way that you can get the likes and clicks, I suggest you get a new profession. Because the man that killed somebody in Tennessee, he ain't doing no jail time because he thought he was being robbed. The man that was choking this other man, he didn't get arrested. Because he was being poked and it was a provocative nature that the guy used against him. So I'm saying to you all, for those of you who are doing it, whether it is you, your kids, or whomever, stop playing with folks out here in these streets. Because these streets got real people with real issues and they ain't got time to be playing. like the baby daddy at McDonald's just for views. Absolutely. I am saying this as a public service announcement to some of you fools. Stop playing with people, because people got real life issues, and you doing something so you can get some clicks on YouTube, or so you can get some likes on Facebook or Twitch or whatever ones that y'all out there on. Stop playing. Okay. Like Chris Rock said, it's just jokes. Yeah, it's just jokes until somebody snap. Like there's a guy out there right now who walks around and he got his cell phone and he got somebody videoing it, and he say something that he know the person is going to hear it. And then he try to talk tough, and then he say, oh, it's just a prank. It's just a joke. Stop playing with people. Because if somebody done had a bad day and you out here playing and you ain't got time to get out there, that's a prank before they put that pistol to your head. That's what happens. Anyway, people, look, I got to get up from out here. We're going to talk about this some more next week. Y'all got some more time. First of all, thanks again, Andre Williams, for having that on your site. If y'all got something y'all want to talk about, or if I see something on your site that is interesting, I'm going to get your permission before I put it up. And then we're going to talk about it. Animal say, I've seen some pranks on social media and a lot of them are not funny. It's crazy. Absolutely. Look, people, again, Andre, thank you for that. It was very informative. It was a deep dive for the day. I want to thank all of y'all. Yeah, including Nikki for the responses. And look here, people, y'all be safe out there. Put your mask on. Don't be getting caught up with the monkey pox or whatever it is. And I'm out.
It's about that time, baby. Oh, yeah. Here we go.